here. So as we are watching the live ministration, do well to use the share button, because the Lord is going to touch somebody's life in the name of Jesus Christ. I'm just going to briefly pray with us, and once I take the prayer, then we're going to continue by the special grace of God. Okay? We are going to look at something little. I'm just going to be here for a few minutes, and basically we are going to look at the ministry of deliverance. The ministry of deliverance, as we are looking at this also, I want you to pray along with me, because something will happen mightily in your life. Something drastic will happen. The Holy Spirit will revive your inner man, and your life is never going to remain the same again in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. So just share and invite others. Heavenly Father, King of all glory, I thank you. I thank you for what you started. I thank you for what you're going to do in the life of your children. Oh Lord, open the eyes of our understanding in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. In the end of this, oh Lord, let your name be glorified. In the name of Jesus, everyone in bondage, everyone in captivity, let that yoke be broken by the power of God in the name of Jesus Christ. And wherever you're watching me from, let the Spirit of the living God, let the power of God touch you like never before in the name of Jesus. Let the sword of the Spirit of God pelt through and destroy every power in the name of Jesus Christ. Beloved, we are going to be looking at just something, the ministry of deliverance. There are many people that are dying in silence. And that's why God has sent me here today. God has sent me here today because somebody is going to receive the truth of the word of God. Every truth you receive must lead you to freedom. That's one thing you must know. If it doesn't lead you to freedom, it's not truth. And secondly speaking also, there is something you must understand. See, when you don't understand the principles that are guiding God's word, it's hard for you to get revelation. So there is something God wants us to understand. First and foremost, what is this deliverance? Deliverance basically is to be set free. To be set free from bondage and captivity. But the first kind of deliverance that a Christian needs, the first deliverance that must be evident in a man's life. See, that's why there's a lot of deliverance program. There's a lot of breaking of chairs. There's a lot of thunder. There's a lot of crying. But there is no impartation. The first deliverance is the deliverance from sin. Deliverance from sin. By the special grace of God, I've been in the deliverance ministry for these few years. And I've come to realize that many people come to the Lord and they don't receive because there is something that they have not uprooted. If the inner man is not being crucified, you cannot receive victory. Listen to me carefully. I'm speaking to you by experience. If there is no crucifixion of the inner man, if there is no daily denial, forget about deliverance. I will show you something from God's word that touch your life. I'm going to be here for a few minutes, but these few minutes, I'm believing that the Holy Spirit will bless your life. The Holy Spirit will touch your life. The Holy Spirit will break that yoke in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Listen to me very much well. First is the deliverance from sin. And second, the thing we'll be looking at is the deliverance from wicked powers. Listen to me. Every sin that a man commits, there is a demon. Every foundational power, there is a demon or there is a principality standing in the way. Now, first and foremost, I want you to learn this. Let's learn how to deal with the powers first. If you can deal with the spiritual authorities, you will get spiritual freedom. I pray God will give us freedom in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Do you know that there are many Christians dying in silence? There are many Christians, they cannot say it out. They cannot speak out, but they are dying in silence. They cannot talk. They are dying from addiction. They are dying from different wicked powers. But listen to me. One of the ways is that you cannot do it on your own. See, the Bible says, Jesus said, I did not come to do my own will, but the will of the Father. Anytime you have decided in your mind not to do your own will, listen to me. That's the first step of deliverance from sin. You are going to see that the Holy Spirit will now begin to give you grace and power to walk in the righteousness of Jesus Christ. See, listen to me. God knows in his infinite mercy you cannot do this thing on your own.
There is so many self-righteousness out there. The minute you try to do it on your own, you will fail. You will not get deliverance. Secondly, speaking again, is deliverance from foundational power. Listen to me. Do you know that every sin that a man commits, do you know one of the reasons why God forgives? Why God forgives is that if the Holy Spirit should open your eyes, that is why you must have sympathy. This is why Jesus is always having compassion for people. Jesus was not looking at the personality sinning. Jesus was looking at the devil, the demon that is allowing that person to live in sin. And this has made me know that I will never meet somebody that is living in sin and condemn the person in my life. You know why? Because I realized that this thing is not by power. This thing is not by strength. It's by the Spirit of God. The ministry of deliverance. You must believe in the servant of God. You must believe in the man of God. Listen to me. If you don't believe in the anointing in that man, you will never receive from him. Look at a scripture in Psalm 118 verse 26. You know what Psalm 118 verse 26 says? It says, blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord. See, blessed is he that cometh. Once he cometh in the name of the Lord, you must understand that he's not coming on his own. The Spirit of the living God is baptizing him to be a blessing to you. The minute you understand this, you will receive deliverance. You cannot receive from what you have not believed in. The second problem here is lack of faith. Lack of faith. Lack of faith. Lack of faith. The Bible says something. It says, who is it that overcometh the world? It's our faith. If you don't have the faith to believe that God can do that thing, listen to me. I've realized that, see, we all know that the opposite of faith is fear, right? Listen to me. That's not just the whole truth about that. Anytime you don't have faith, what you are only telling God is that, you see, you are not bigger than that problem. Anytime you tell God you are not bigger than that problem, God will never be bigger than that problem. That problem, you must see it as it is too little for Jesus to deal with. That's the audacity of faith. There was a particular sister I met some times back. When she knew me, I was an unbeliever. But the minute she came to me and then we began to pray, I was a believer by then. And this sister, just a little word of prayer, she did not see me as an unbeliever. Now she saw me as a believer. Now Chidozie is in Christ Jesus. Listen to me. The minute a declaration was made upon her life, she just called me and said, sir, please, I got what I was asking for. She has gone to places, but I got what I was asking for. I said to myself, who did this thing? See, listen to me. That's the power of Jesus. She was not looking at me. She knows that naturally speaking, I cannot do anything. But when you see him as an oracle of God, you will begin to get that deliverance. The Lord is going to touch somebody's life. The Lord is going to deliver you from every captivity. I want us to know the dimensions. I want us to know the principles. I want us to know how to be able to achieve these things. And we are going to get it in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Another thing is the revelation of God's word. See, listen to me. I've realized it's not by reading all the whole scripture. Every day, you know, one of the prayers I make, I tell God, give me a revelation of the word. Any little revelation of the word you have, I'm telling you, your life will change. Your life will change. In short, every revelation of the word you get leads to deliverance. Automatically, as long as it enters into your spirit, every revelation of the word of God you get, it will lead to deliverance. You know the problem? The problem is that we read the word, but we don't understand the word. And anytime you understand the word, it will make impact in your life. If it was not making impact in your life, it has not entered into your spirit, man. Anytime it enters into your spirit, man, you will get deliverance. You will get deliverance. It's not by shaking, it's not by turning. In short, God does not even want you to shake. God wants you to stand when his spirit is moving. Listen to me. That's the authority that we now have in Christ Jesus. It's not about shaking. It's not about moving. No, no, no. Something evidently can happen in your life even without all those gymnastics. The ministry of deliverance. The ministry of deliverance. The ministry of deliverance. There are also three important keys I want you to understand. First and foremost, there must be freedom from sin. You must have faith in the Lord Jesus Christ and humility of spirit. Listen to me. If you don't humble yourself to any pastor, any man of God, you might just be saying, what is he saying? Is he trying to praise somebody? He's not praising somebody. God does not work in a man's life except he will use another man. You know what I've realized? Many of the things we are praying, God, where's my divine helper? God, your divine helper is just close to you. It is because of the spirit of pride you could not see it. You could not see the man that God has anointed to lift you up from poverty, to lift you up from all kinds of powers. You know why? Pride. pride. You see, pride is the root of every sin on planet Earth. Pride leads to self. After self, it will bring about sin. Pride is the spirit of self-righteousness. I can do it on my own. I can do it on my own. I can do it on my own. And then you are drowning. When you know that, see, the things that you are looking for, God placed it in a man that is close to you there so that he can use it to deliver you. But you must see through the eyes of Jesus. Don't look at him. Look at the power of God that is able to do that work. The ministry of deliverance. God is going to do something mighty in our life in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I'm just going to pray along with us. I don't have so much of time, but I want you to know. Listen to me. There are some certain things that are abnormal in the life of the child of God. It is abnormal for a child of God to have spiritual wives and spiritual husbands. It's abnormal for a child of God not to remember his dream. It's abnormal. You know, there are many people at the edge of their breakthrough. I've seen so many problems. I've seen so many things. In short, there was a particular city I traveled to for a kind of crusade, a kind of program. Do you know what I realized there? Everybody there was suffering because of the blood of a man that was shed in that particular place. But listen to me carefully. Do you know something that happened there? After that program, as long as the people were brought and they said, do you want to receive Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior? To be very much sincere with you and candid with you, the yokes were instantly broken. Sin is a barrier. Sin is demonic. Sin is devilish. If you remove that, you are 50% halfway to your deliverance. God will touch you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Every yoke of darkness standing in the way, every power that doesn't want you to serve the Lord Jesus Christ, every wicked spirit, the Bible says Christ has redeemed us from the curse of the law. Have faith. That power, you can't stop me. That devil, you can't stop me. That demon, you can't stop me. I am a child of God. Even if I'm not a preacher, I am a child of God. You don't have power, you don't have audacity over my life. Get away in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Something mighty will happen in your life. It's your brother, Anele Silventus Chedozie. God bless you all in Jesus' name. Share to others. And I believe that this ministry of deliverance will touch you. Meet me up every 3 p.m. God bless you. In Jesus Christ's name we pray. Amen.
We know you have been richly blessed by this end-time heavenly message from the man of God. Anele Chedozie is an end-time preacher sent by the Lord Jesus Christ with encounters of heaven, hell, and the kingdom of darkness to prepare the earth for the rapture with power. As he travels worldwide preaching the gospel and the reality of heaven, you can directly write, call, or WhatsApp the man of God on +234 903 53 22790. And also for more end time materials, books, messages, and to fellowship with us, Rapture Ready End Time Movement Ministry Worldwide. Don't miss out of the weekly meetings, power-packed miracle deliverance service every Friday tagged My Heavens Must Open, and Sunday fire service by 9 a.m. at REM Zoom Satellite Worldwide Fellowship and REM Headquarters at Maya Ikorodu, Lagos, Nigeria, and to directly meet one-on-one with the man of God for partnership, crusade booking, testimonies, more end-time messages and inquiries. Write to us at remworldwide@gmail.com or Facebook, YouTube, Tweet or Instagram with Anele Silventus Chedozie, and visit www.onlinerevival.org. Be a part of the last day revival with undiluted holiness and power, power like the days of old. We know you have been richly blessed by